Now, Cajuns love to advise, give advice and help people out. And I want to share this with y'all. To all the bald-headed men, and the bald-headed men to be, because some of y'all are going to join us, don't never wear a white turtleneck sweater. No white turtleneck sweater. It makes us look too much like a roll-on deodorant. No. You know, when I was preparing this talk, I couldn't help but think of how many of the Cajun characteristics fit into the idea I wanted to talk about today. And to me, this is the most powerful of all psychological and metaphysical concepts. And don't get worried, I know that was serious and I meant it to be, but my serious span's about 2 minutes. All right. And I like them big words. How you like that? That's some good big words. I use a lot of big words. Watermelon, eucalyptus, pistachio. No, the idea I want to share with you, Dr. Carl Menninger just said this. If we could get this one idea that we want to talk about this morning into our consciousness, then 80% of those irritating distractions that are so much of our daily lives would never reach the problem stage. One idea, 80%, that's what we're going to talk about. My granddaughter, Heidi, and the children y'all work with, man, you can get books of material from them. But she came up to me one day, she said, Big D, let me tell you this poem I learned in school today. I said, okay, Heidi, let me tell you, show me the poem, tell me the poem. Now I lay me down to rest. I pray to pass tomorrow's test. If I should die before I wake, that's one less test I'll have to take. And I said all that to say this, to give you the saying that my wife Audrey gave to me. If you ever think you're too small to make a difference, you have never been in bed with a mosquito. It is, because they brought us the Texas Aggies. How many Aggies? As an Aggie? Hook 'em horns. Okay. Where's the Texas Aggie? Oh, I got two of them. Hot dog. I went to LSU, Cher. I love them Aggies. This happened. LSU and Texas A&M been playing each other for 100 years. And this is right before the big game of the year, A&M against LSU. And in the mathematics class, the professor got up and he said, I'm sorry. The star football player, the fullback that they had to have, is failing mathematics, and he ain't gonna be able to play in the game Saturday. The whole class jumped up on their chairs and said, let him pass, Prof, let him pass, we need him. He said, okay, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll ask him one more question, and if he gets that right, he can play in the game Saturday. How much is 8 times 8? 8 times 8. He said, 8 times 8 is 64. Man, the whole class jumped up on their chairs. They said, let him pass anyway. Let him pass anyway. Here's the lesson I learned, and I hope I can get through to y'all on it. I don't know if I made any of those other people happy. I hope I did, and I think I did, but I'm not sure. I really don't know how they took it. What I do know is, by me doing all that, it kept my attitude up. And that's the key to it. See, there's so many things I want to talk to y'all about. Y'all my kind of group, but I'll give you a couple more things. We need to laugh more. Ladies, if you don't laugh, everything goes to your hips. I want you to meet, because I really didn't get as much as I wanted to, and it's not what happens to you that makes the difference. It's how you react to what happens. So I want you to meet my wife of over 50 years. Stand up, Audra. She's a perfect example of what I'm talking about. She's had over 13 operations. In fact, they're thinking of putting a zipper on her stomach so they'll save time. But she's always bubbly, always happy. And people always ask her, they say, Audra, don't you ever wake up grouchy? No, I never wake up grouchy. I let him sleep.